Everyone, I'm Poojita from Talent Battle. Welcome to our new video. In this video, we are going to check some questions for game-based aptitude round for Capgemini exam. This video is going to give you a clear idea about the game-based aptitude round and how it will appear in your exam. As we know, Capgemini is going to hire 2022 batch students soon. This video will help you to prepare for that. You can also join our master classes, which will cover all the sections that appear in Capgemini, like game-based aptitude round, English communication test, pseudocode, and behavior round. You can also join our social media platforms like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. We constantly give updates on placement preparations and off-campus placements. Links for all of this are in the description box. So before we start, do not forget to subscribe for our channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications from us. So we will start. Game-based aptitude round consists of various challenges, and one of the challenge that you can expect is a switch challenge, and this is how the question will appear in your exam. So first, let's try to understand exactly what is this switch challenge, and then I will be even presenting you a demo to show you exactly how it will appear in your exam. So switch challenge, observe this particular word switch. They are going to switch the positions of the input. Input is nothing but the given data for you in the starting. So they will switch the positions of this particular input to get this particular output. So we need to identify what is the function that is performed to get this output. So the function might be either 1342, or the function might be 3214, or it can be 4132, or it can be even 2314. So how do we identify? It's actually an easy challenge. So what you need to do is observe here, everything is in forms of number. So let us try giving number for the input. So exactly given the same order they appear. So plus is 1, square is 2, circle is 3, and the triangle is 4. Now, once if you give the numberings for the input, check your output in which order they appear. Now, first circle came, that means 3 is performed first. So 3 should come first, and then it's a square, which is nothing but 2, and then it's a plus, which is nothing but 1 here, plus, and then it's a triangle, which is nothing but 4. That means for this input, you performed the switch arrangements, the switch challenge, nothing but the positions you switched is 3, 2, 1, 4 to get this output. So what is the answer? All you need to do in your exam is just to click on this particular option. So if you click on this particular option, it will automatically register your answer. Now I'll be showing you a demo also how it will appear. So just have a look at the demo video. This is how the question will appear in your exam. So if you observe on the top, there is a timer for 6 minutes, and all you need to do is just select on the option. So once if you select, it will automatically move to the next level like this. So again, you need to select your answer. So once if you select, again, it will automatically move to the next level. So you can reach as many levels as you can until the 6 minutes of timer is done. So every challenge, they will give you 6 minutes of time. So you need to complete as many levels as you can in that particular 6 minutes. And this is how exactly it will be in your exam. The next challenge that you can expect in game-based aptitude round is called as a digit challenge. And this is how the question will appear on your screen. So first I will explain you exactly what is the digit challenge, and then I will even present you the demo video how it will exactly appear in your exam. Now, so here, they will give you a figure in this particular manner, and you need to complete this particular equation, whichever they give. So here what happened? A number multiplied with another number, and then you added it to other number, you need to get the resultant as 45. So first thing, whenever you are solving the problems of digit challenge, when you are going through this challenge, you need to keep completely Bode-Moss rule into mind. You should always perform the simplifications by using only this Bode-Moss rule. That means brackets of, if there are brackets, first brackets you should solve. And then division, D for division, and then M for multiplication, addition, and subtraction. That means first division should be performed, and then multiplication should be performed, and then addition, and then subtraction should be performed. That means first here, this multiplication should be performed. After this multiplication, you need to add a number so that you need to get 45. And the basic rule of this particular challenge is you are supposed to use the digits which are appearing on your screen. That's it. Only this particular digits. You are not supposed to use zero because that is not appearing on your screen. Yes. And the next thing, you are not supposed to repeat the digits. For example, if I used one, I'm not supposed to repeat one again. If I used five, I'm not supposed to repeat five again. So in your exam, all you need to do is just click on the particular number. It will automatically register the answer. For example, if I click on one, here the first position one will occupy. If you think this one is wrong, then you can click on this delete button. So automatically this particular one will be removed. I will present you the demo video also. Now let's try to solve this one. So a number into another number plus this one should give you 45, right? So what are the options that are possible? First, you are considering this particular thing as one number and this is another number. So to get 45, various ways we can do. For example, 44 plus 1 we can do, or 43 plus 2 we can do, or 42 plus 4 we can, 42 plus 3 we can do. Like this, we can perform various operations. Right, so let's check with the first thing. 44, if I take, I need to write it as 11 into 4. But 11 I can't use because 1 will be repeating 2 times. So let me remove this 43, it's a prime I can't use. Now let me check with 42. How can I write 42? I can actually write 42 as 7 into 6. So this will be 42 plus the next one will be 3. See, none of the numbers is repeated. And the equation satisfied the condition for 45. So 7 into 6 plus 3 is nothing but 45. And there might be multiple options which are possible for an equation. So don't worry about all the answers. You can give one answer which satisfies the equation. There are multiple answers that you can give for the equation. So you can just click on one particular answer and make sure the digits are not repeating. Now all you need to do in exam, so here my answer is 7 into 6 plus 3. So all you need to do in exam, first click on 7. So it will register 7 here, and then click on 6. It will register 6 here, and then click on 3. So it will register 3 here. Now I'll be even showing you the demo video, how it will appear in your exam. So let's see the demo video now. And this is how it will exactly appear in your exam. So there won't be on the top also complete the equation. They will just give you this particular figure. All you need to do is just click on the correct answer. So automatically it will go to the next level once if you click. So again, you need to select the digits. So see, observe how carefully it is going on. So just select the digits, it will move ahead. Now, for example, if any of the digits that you clicked is wrong, so how it will be? Now observe this particular example here. So first you selected 6, fine. Now you thought 6 is wrong. So you can just click on 6. Now automatically click on delete, it will delete. So now you can click the particular number which is supposed to be replaced with 6. Yes. So that's how it will be exactly in your exam. The next challenge that you can see in your exam is a motion challenge. And this is how it will appear. I will be even showing you a demo video. First, let me explain you exactly what is the challenge. Now, all you need to do in this particular challenge is to take this red ball into the black hole which is appearing here. So when the red ball is supposed to move to the black hole, there shouldn't be any kind of obstacles like this. So you need to clear the path first for the red ball to move to this black hole. So they will give you some blocks which are not allowing the red ball to pass. So we need to clear the way first. So to clear the way, first thing, for example, if you take this particular yellow block here, the yellow block can be moved towards the right side. Here it is not there, but generally it can be moved towards the right side. It can be moved towards the left side. It can be moved towards the downside and it can be moved towards the upside. But you can't rotate this particular block. If it is in vertical, it's vertical. If it is in horizontal, it is horizontal. That's it. You can't rotate it, but you can move them up, down, left and right. Now, firstly, the red ball need to pass to this black hole. That means I need to remove this yellow block. But I can't move it to the top because here already this position is occupied by the blue and the maroon. And I can't even move it to the left because already orange block is here. So once already a block is here, you can't move it. The plane surface should be like this. Then only you can move the blocks here. For example, this maroon block, I can move to the down because the place here is a plane surface. But here I can't move the yellow block. So I can't do any kind of changes to the yellow block. So what else I should do? And one more thing, whenever you are performing this challenge, try to finish in as many minimum steps as you can and try to consume as much less time that you can. So yellow block case is not going to happen. Let me keep the yellow block case aside for some time. For example, if I think like this, the red ball can come here, it can make the move and it can come here. That means I need to move this orange block. I can easily move the orange block on the left side because this place is empty, right? So I can easily move this orange block on the left side. Once if the orange block moves to the left side, I can easily make the red ball pass in this particular way. So first step, what I'm going to do, I'm going to move this particular orange block to the left side. Okay, so left side. And this is how it will appear once we move it to the left side. Now one step is done. So the next step, take your cursor and just move it. It will be done. Now the next step, the red ball is supposed to pass to here. That means up to here it will pass. This is one more step. So two steps are done. In the down, the steps will also be counted. In your exam, in the down, it will be appearing for you. Two steps are done, three steps are done like that. I will be showing you the demo video for that. So now second step is done. Next, again, taking a path like this. So this is one more step. So from here to here, it's directly one step. That's it. It won't be counted like three steps or four steps here. It's just a one step. All you need to do, just click on this and just drag it here. That is one step. And now one more step, which is third step. And next here, up to here, this would be one more step, which is fourth step, and then here. So this would be fifth step. So in five steps here, we can drag this particular red ball into the black hole, which is appearing here. Okay, so that's how we do. And the basic rules of this particular game is a block cannot be rotated. It can be moved to the top or to the down or to the left or right, but it cannot be rotated. And it can be moved only in this kind of plane surfaces. If already a block is occupying the positions here, you need to first move these blocks and then only you can move the next blocks. That is the first thing. And there is one more thing that for time being, you can place these blocks on the black hole also for time being. But when the red ball needs to pass, you need to clear the way for that. But for the time being, you can even place them there also. Now I will show you the demo video. It will give you a clear idea how it will appear in your exam. So let's see the demo video now. And this is how it will exactly appear in your exam. So the time period is on the top. And if you make the movement, the step will be counted. See here, one step done and then again step. So once the red ball passes, it will move to the next level. So again, if you do the movement, the count of the steps will be taken in the down. If you observe in the bottom, the steps counting is already mentioning there. So you need to pass the red ball and then the next level will open. You can do as many levels you can until the 6 minutes of timer is done. Once the timer is done, it will automatically move to the next challenge. So you need to clear the way for the red ball to pass over to the black hole. And this is how it will exactly appear in your exam. The next challenge that you can expect in your exam is a grid challenge. This is a quite interesting challenge. First, I will explain you how exactly the grid challenge questions will be. And then I'll be playing you the demo video how it will be there in your exam. So first, they will give you the appearance of dots like this. Among these dots, one dot will be highlighted. and this will appear on your screen only just for 2 seconds of time. That's it. You need to remember where this particular dot appears. So if you observe, the dot is here, which is highlighted. So you need to remember this dot. Only 2 seconds of time will be there for you to remember this dot. Now, automatically, this will appear on your screen after 2 seconds of time. And they will give you 7 seconds of the time, 5 to 7 seconds of the time to answer for this question. So they are going to ask you, are this symmetrical? So are this symmetrical? So symmetrical means what? They should be exactly like the mirror images. So are these two like the mirror images? That is what you need to check. So are these two like the mirror images? See, everything should be same. Either the height, either the width of the dots, everything should be same. If you observe here, the height is not seen here. That means these are not mirror images. So what you need to do, you need to click on no. And it will be only 7 seconds of time for you to answer for this question. Even if you answer or if you don't answer also, after 7 seconds, automatically the next slide will appear on your screen, which is again 2 seconds of time for you to remember one more dot which is highlighted. So if you see here, one more dot is already highlighted. Now, again after 2 seconds, they will give you one more question like, are these symmetrical? So this question is just to make you divert, to forget the dots where they are darkened. So are this symmetrical? So observe, are these two like the mirror images? Are they exactly same? Yes, they are like the mirror images. They symmetry means they should be like the mirror images itself. So they are like the mirror images. So now you need to click on S, and then after 7 seconds, automatically it will show you the next one. And now here they are going to ask you, what is the sequence of the dots appeared? So the first dot appeared here, and the second dot appeared here. So you need to click exactly this, the first one, and this, the second one. Then only it will be the correct one. If you click this first and that second, that will be the wrong, because the sequence of the appearance of the dots. So first this appeared and then this appeared. So this is how the grid challenge will be. So you need to remember where the position of the dots appear to divert you. They will give you something called, are they symmetrical or not? You need to answer for that. And again, they will show you one more dot which is highlighted. And again, they will ask you the sequence of the dots. As the level increases, the number of dots that you need to remember will also increase. Now, I will show you the demo video. It will give you a clear idea how it will be exactly in your exam. So let's see the demo video now. And this is how it will exactly appear in your exam. So 2 seconds of time, the dot is appeared highlighted. And then are this symmetrical? Is it symmetrical? Yes. And again, 2 seconds of time, another dot is highlighted. And again, 7 seconds of time, are they symmetrical? Yes. Again, one more dot is also here, 3 dots. So again, yes or no, you need to click. Now they're asking you, what is the grid in which the otter appeared? So you need to select it, and then it will move to the next level. So observe this example also. 2 seconds, done. And then again, 7 seconds, symmetry or not. Next, again, one more dot highlighted, 2 seconds, done. And next, again, 7 seconds, symmetry or not. Now again, one more dot highlighted. And again, they're going to ask whether it is symmetry or not. And then they are going to ask you, one more dot has appeared here, and then again symmetry or not. Now the order of the dots. So total, in total, 4 dots. You need to submit, then the next level will open. And this is how it will be in your exam. Now we will see one more question upon grid challenge. Isn't it little difficult to remember the appearance of the dots? Now I will teach you a small trick. Okay, so now when the screen appears, they will just give you 2 seconds of time, right? So just place any of your finger on the particular dot which is appearing. So you can use your left hand. Now I'm going to place one finger on this particular dot. I'm just going to place a finger. Now automatically the screen will remove. I mean, the next slide will appear. So don't remove your finger. Just place the finger on the first dot itself. So you can just remember which finger you need to place on the first dot. I'm going to use my 4th finger here. Now, again, are they symmetrical? Don't remove your finger, answer it. Are they symmetrical or not? Just check whether everything is exactly in the same order. They should be exactly in the form of the mirror images. So they are in the form of the mirror images. So just click on S. So automatically it will go ahead. Now again appear. So use your one more finger and press the finger on the particular dot. Okay. So I used my one more finger and place the finger on the dot. Now automatically the screen gone. Again, are they symmetrical? So you need to observe whether they are symmetrical or not. And don't remove your fingers. Okay. So just observe. Are they symmetrical? Yes, they are symmetrical. So just click on S. And then automatically the screen will change. Here one more dot. Now you need to place one more finger of yours on this particular dot. Okay, you can just remember which finger you need to place for the first position, second position and third position. Now again, it will go to the next slide. Are they symmetrical? So are they symmetrical here? They are not symmetrical because they are exactly the same figures. They are not the mirror images. That means this is wrong. They are not symmetrical. Now the next question appears. Now, what is the sequence of the dots appeared? Already our fingers are on the screen. So this is the first dot appeared and this is the second dot appeared and this is the third dot appeared. See, you can easily remember by using the help of the finger. So this one you need to click first and then this one and then this one. So how many ever more, you can just use your fingers and then you can answer. This is just a small trick. I hope you like the trick. So you can use it if you can be able to answer and remember the dots by using this trick. Okay. Thank you for watching the video till the end. If you like the video, do not forget to press the like button. And also join our social media platforms like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. Link for all of this or in the description box. Thank you.